It's 8 p.m. on a Friday night, and you just got back from taking your final exam of the semester. You walk to your room, sit at your desk, and after a bit of pondering, you decide to play Scarlet Nexus, an RPG game that you've been playing a lot of lately. After playing for a bit, the standby phase kicks in, and you decide to walk away. But why? By all means, you should keep going, and you should keep progressing in this game, but you don't. So why did you stop? Now you might answer something along the lines of, oh, I was tired, or I have something to do in the morning, so I should get some rest. But the real answer is, I want this to last. I want this moment, this feeling to last. I want the characters that I've grown to love last. Maybe though, you are tired, or maybe you do have something to do in the morning, but if you are someone that walked away from a game because you knew that the good times weren't going to last, then congrats. You have metathesiophobia. I'm kidding, you probably don't have that, and if you do, then you should probably go play a few horror games that utilize this phobia really well. No, what you do have is a fear of the end, or to put it simply, you're scared of post-series depression. This term goes by many names, post-series depression, post-game depression, sadness, post-nut clarity. The point is there's a lot of names, but they all sum up to the same thing, which is a sad or empty feeling that a lot of us, and even myself, have experienced after finishing a show or a game we like. Put it in a better term, it's that feeling of what now after you say, for example, finish binge watching The Case Study of Benitez, which I actually need to get back to watching, but regardless, you're scared of post-series depression. Or maybe you're not scared of it. Maybe you're scared of what the story will do to your characters. Maybe you see that your characters are all happy or at a good point in their lives and you don't want to ruin that, because you know that the good times will soon come to an end. So you figure that instead of progressing the game and watching the characters you love die in front of you, you'd stop. You'd stop so this moment of joy, while brief and present in the rest of the game, can last. I firmly believe though that this fear of not only change, but the change will come to the characters we love is why so many people gravitate towards games that don't have an ending, or that can be played online with friends. It's why so many people stop playing a story-rich game to play other ones like Risk of Rain 2 or Apex Legends. It's to provide not only a brief break, but also to prolong the joy and happiness that you and the characters you've grown close to last. However, like all things, you eventually have to pick up that controller and press continue. Hey, wow, you actually made it to the end of the video. That's great. Good for you. Before I go, I'd like to say that if you want to see more of me or my content, then feel free to subscribe to my other channel and follow my Twitch channel, where I frequently stream games and other fun stuff. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed the video, and I'll see you later.